All right. So we don't ask people to search for seven anymore.
So we're about to do two different demos that do two different things. And the first one is these exam blue books that, thankfully, as of this year, we don't use anymore.
A lot of classes still do, I think. I don't understand these blue books.
But why do we use our blue books?
I think someone bought like a lot of them 20 years ago, and they're still using
them. We're using the same supply that we got in 1994.
So the opportunity at hand for this demonstration, in my mind, is to invite a student up. They are handed 26 blue books, on top of which are 26 names, which in reality we simplify as just A through Z. And the goal is to have a student not struggle, so to speak, with the sorting of a pseudo-random permutation of these books, to see really how they do it. This is not hard, so long as you know your A's through your Z's, like, it's easy to do, but it's interesting, I think, to observe the student do it and have him or her verbalize what it is they just did, and see if we can glean from that experience some germ of an idea, something algorithmic that we can then formalize.
Right, because usually when you're sorting, you're just looking at it, you're thinking about it, you're not saying, well, I'm gonna put well, this is the E, so it's gonna have to go after the D, or I'm gonna put it in this pile temporarily while I figure out what to do with the rest of it. In there, like you said, there are these little germs of things that we'll see when we talk about the formalized algorithms of selection sort, insertion sort, bubble sort.
I mean, it's much like in week zero when we do the very intuitive, I think, divide and conquer, looking for Mike Smith in the phone book, but then we take a step back and try to formalize it with pseudocode and put to paper or put to the screen exactly what it is we were thinking, and trying to teach students how to express that and ultimately how to leverage that. The downside, I will say, of a demo like this is you never know what you're gonna get in the way of the actual student's experience. Sometimes it goes well, sometimes it doesn't go well. In terms of the pedagogy of it, sometimes the student does it so quickly or so well, accidentally or algorithmically, that there's not much to talk about. And so the reality is it's actually nice when a student struggles a little bit or gets hung up for a moment, has to think, because that's an opportunity to jump in and say, all right, what's the decision point here, right? Like, what's the fork in the road, the decision you're trying to make? And here we have, thanks to the production team and over the shoulder camera angle, so that we can actually see that B is there, about to be sorted.
Yeah, especially with a demo like this, where things are actually fairly small, it's nice to be able to project this on the screen for people who are watching live or watching after the fact to see these steps side by side.
And I do think these kinds of demos hopefully make things very real, right? Like, at the end of the day, it's kind of daunting for a lot of students to be in a computer science class, and yet, like, this is very accessible. Like, even if no one knows what a blue book is anymore, you at least know that, like, sorting, okay, this is something I've probably had to do at some point. Let me see if I can't clean this up now and start to formalize and leverage this.
Right.